It's time for business. I'm Joy Doreen Bira. The World Bank has trimmed Kenya's economic outlook for 2015 from 6% to 5.4% owing to a combination of exogenous shocks in the financial markets and the contractionary monetary stance occasioned by a high interest rate environment. Adelaide Chingole tells us on this week's edition of Cause and Effect.
2015 began with great optimism, with both the government and development partners banking on increased consumer spending, higher public and private investment, and the dividend from the massive investments in infrastructure to drive growth.
The economy is expected to expand further by between 6.5% to 7% in 2015.
The growth targets earned Kenya great praise and formed a critical part of the President's State of the Nation address in March.
Of the 57 fastest growing economies ranked by Bloomberg, Kenya was the third fastest growing economy behind China and the Philippines.
But 10 months into the year, and consumers have been hit by a weaker shilling that has shed 19% of its value against the dollar since September last year. On top of that, consumers are feeling the impact of the tighter monetary stance brought about by the 3% increase in the benchmark central bank rate to 11.5%. This has translated into higher lending rates and slower private sector growth.
If the supply of credit is constrained, to the wider Kenyan public, that will not spur economic activity and that will have an impact on growth.
And while the country has continued investing in infrastructure, its revenue streams have been handicapped internally by the slowdown in private sector spending and externally by the lower commodity prices that have been prevalent this year and the slower economic growth in the Eurozone region. As a result, the government has found itself relying ever more on debt to finance its infrastructural expansion.
The fiscal deficit in 2011-2012 was 4.5%. It is projected to be 8.7% this year, in the current fiscal year. Last year, which ended in June, it was 8.3%. By any standard, this is not sustainable.
And now the World Bank says Kenya cannot achieve its target of 6% economic growth this year, revising the estimates downward to 5.4%.
The way the central bank has jacked up interest rates, that will going to affect aggregate demand, and that is going to reduce growth for 2015.
The World Bank is now calling on the government to rethink its expenditure strategy, saying it was time to trim the fat in order to ensure the long-term sustainability of the country's debt position.
We know that what we are spending our money on is okay. It's opening the productive space of the country. The country can produce more and grow much faster and achieve the 10% growth rate. But you have to live within your means at some times.
It's always ideal to identify priority sectors and provide all the resources to those priority sectors and those that are not of immediate urgency, although they may be positive for the economy, but the resources are finite, so you cannot put in place all the projects at the same time.
Interestingly, Kenya still remains one of the fastest growing economies in Africa. According to the World Bank, even at the revised estimate of 5.4%, Kenya's outlook is higher than its peers in the sub-Saharan region, who are expected to post an average growth rate of 3.8% for 2015. Adelaide Chingole for Cause and Effect.